A lot of history. James, thank you. Now, to another shoe dropping from that upcoming book, Clinton Cash, by Peter Schweitzer. It involves how reconstruction projects in one devastated Caribbean nation have huge financial implications and also have the Clinton fingerprints all over them.
January 12, 2010. Haiti suffers a devastating 7.0 earthquake. The epicenter is about 15 miles west of its most populous city, Port-au-Prince. More than 200,000 die, and over 100,000 buildings and homes are destroyed. Within 4 days, U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton arrives to survey the damage.
I want to assure the people of Haiti that the United States is a friend, a partner, and a supporter.
2 days later, former President Clinton was on the ground.
I hope that it will be rebuilt in a much stronger and more sustainable way, and I think the Haitians want that.
Bill Clinton had previously been named UN Special Envoy for Haiti. He and Hillary had close ties with the country, even honeymooning there. Hillary's State Department, working with USAID, the United States Agency for International Development, would oversee America's relief effort. The government of Haiti set up the IHRC, Interim Haiti Recovery Commission, to coordinate. Two men were named co-chairs of the IHRC Executive Committee, Haitian Prime Minister Jean-Max Bellerive and Bill Clinton himself. The idea was to not just fix things, but improve them. In an interview with Esquire, President Clinton had big plans, saying, quote, "Wouldn't it be great if they became the first wireless nation in the world? They could. I'm telling you, they really could." But it wasn't at all clear that the people of Haiti would be the big winners in the disaster relief gold rush.
Anytime there's a natural disaster anywhere, there is a lot of money potentially to be made in reconstruction contracts and relief contracts, etc.
Peter Schweitzer is the author of the new book, Clinton Cash, where he investigates the snarl of money, politics, and personal interest that has come to characterize the Clintons' interactions around the world. Clinton Cash is published by HarperCollins, a sister company to Fox News.
Shortly after the earthquake took place, U.S. Ambassador in Haiti sent a cable to the State Department, the title of which was "The Gold Rush is On." And the memo was about the fact that businessmen and companies were showing up in Haiti trying to seek lucrative contracts.
It was the job of the IHRC to oversee this process and to ensure no one took advantage of the situation. But what if it was part of the problem?
A number of members of the IHRC actually wrote a letter expressing their concerns that they were not involved in the process, that all the decisions were being made by Clinton and Bellerive. In addition, they claimed and argued that the national priorities of Haiti were basically being totally disregarded by the decisions that were being made.
As Haiti dug itself out of the rubble, many projects were initiated, often with U.S. money and a connection to the Clintons.
Thank you.
For instance, there was the Haitian Mobile Money Initiative, where a much-needed system was created to help transfer money via cell phones. There was also a plan to raise money by exploiting Haiti's rich mineral wealth.
The Haitian government announces that they're going to offer two so-called gold exploitation permits, the first issued in 50 years in Haiti, that would allow for the extraction and gold mining in the country.
Perhaps the most celebrated project of all was Caracol Industrial Park.
What is happening here in Caracol is already having ripple effects that will create jobs and opportunities far beyond this industrial park.
The grand opening of Caracol was a big deal. You had Bill Clinton there. You had Hillary Clinton there. You had Donna Karen, the fashion designer. You had Ben Stiller. You had Sean Penn. Lots of people showed up to say how wonderful this facility was going to be for everybody.
But as all these projects moved forward, questions were raised. The central question, the question which Schweitzer investigated, was about how so many of these deals seemed to come back at some point to the Clintons.
And what quickly became apparent to many people was that if you wanted a contract, if you wanted to do business in Haiti, you had to have relationships with the Clinton. That was absolutely key.
The company that cleaned up on the cell phone transfers was Digicel.
In the 6 months running up to September 2012, they took in more than $50 million in revenue in Haiti.
Digicel is run by Irish billionaire Dennis O'Brien, who set up lucrative speeches for Bill Clinton, as well as donating millions of his own money to the Clinton Foundation. And one company that got a rare gold permit was VCS Mining, which didn't actually have much mining experience, but would soon have Hillary Clinton's brother, Tony Rodham, on its board. As for the Caracol Industrial Park, the anchor tenant is a Korean manufacturer, which supplies to major U.S. retailers, who also happen to be big Clinton supporters. And while the State Department promised 65,000 jobs, to date, only 5,000 have been delivered.